the Dolphins going up against the Bills.
Larry, we have played 266 games in this NFL season. Only one remains, and it's the biggest of them all, as EA Sports is proud to present coverage of the Super Bowl. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. The eyes of the world upon us tonight as Super Bowl 52 from Minneapolis is underway. On the return, it's Brandon Tate. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. First carry for LeSean McCoy. And he will not only not get the yard he needed, he goes the wrong direction. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing that defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it in every position. We just saw there some linebackers in the sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble. Three and out, a real danger here on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 12. From the gun, it's Taylor. And he fires one that's intercepted.
Picked off by Rashawn Jones.
And he'll bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. It was third down defensively. They were just hoping to make a play and get off the field, get their offense on. Instead, they did one better. Pick it off, take it into the end zone.
Well, they did what you said. They got it.
They're going to have to come right back on.
They're going to come right back on, but happily, right? They put the ball in the end zone. That's the way you start a game. That's the way you set the tone.
Now Andrew Frank's on for the point after. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Here's Walter Powell on the return. The Bills offense coming out, ready to take over. Here on first down. And his throw here is incomplete. Sammy Watkins, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. And let's run through the Dolphins' defense.
One of the more underrated yet valuable positions in the NFL is safety, and Rashawn Jones epitomizes what you're looking for. A guy that can drop down into the box in the run game and tackle those bigger, stronger running backs.
Can
also cover people, whether it's tight ends or bigger
slots. Taylor, he lost the football. And fortunately for him, he's able to get it back, but it will be a loss on the play.
That's a big oops right there. But how about his ability to correct it? Loses the football, able to get it back himself.
And bounce right back on it, keeps possession. Third and long. Taylor and company open to regroup after the sack. From the shotgun, it's Taylor. And some room to work. For a gain of 31. And now first down following that long game. That was Taylor. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Byron Maxwell. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line.
Well, the timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Steps away to his left. He's going to let one go. That's caught inside the 20.
Yeah!
The way in for a Miami touchdown. Devontae Parker, 53 yards. And the Dolphins strike quickly here for 6 points. It took them a while to get their speedster involved, but they found it downfield there.
And what we've discovered as we've watched games is the speedster doesn't have to have a lot of catches. They don't have to have volume in order to have a huge impact on the game. His speed scares the heck out of defenses, and other guys can capitalize. But when you finally hit him and he carries it all the way into the end zone, that's what you're paying him for. That big threat that can make big plays on a limited number of catches.
That's how you step on the stage with your first catch, take it to the house. And we can break that scoring drive down pretty easily. One play, long touchdown pass into the end zone. Here's Franks now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And now out come the Bills. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start your ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think they're going to stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. So one corner down here in the Super Bowl. 14-0 is our score. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter about to get underway with the Bills in possession. They've got a second down and 8 to start things out. Taylor. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Sammy Watkins, the intended target, and it's third down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
On third down, Taylor. And this is going to be incomplete. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Schmidt on to punt as he sends it away. This is taken at about the 14. Look at the dance of the juke. And yet again, might have been one man away from 6 points. As it stands, it's a huge return. And the Dolphins will begin this drive in great field position, first and 10. The Dolphins' offense now heads back on the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. Maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having having a letdown. It was really easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here.
You're down two touchdowns. You just know defensively. You absolutely have to come up with a big play. That nearly was one right there.
Looked over at the sideline immediately after the drop and just saw the dejection. They felt it. They thought he had it. Unfortunately, couldn't come up with it. Devontae Parker was the intended receiver. Third down here. They're going for a receiver there. Already has one touchdown in his first half. A second one not to be. But he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Gerald Hodges with a big-time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of seven. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We'll come back on Super Bowl Sunday after this. A reminder, coming up at the intermission, we'll get highlights of the Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. This one away by the punter, Dar. And this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard.
They're soul searching now?
I would say so. And they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've got to be on the field more than normal, but in some tough spots. But that's the old adage. When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
Step off the 5 yards.
Yeah, partner, you know, defensive end, he wants to get into the offensive backfield. He wants that get off to be as fast as possible.
Here we go.
A little too quick.
Out of the gun, it's Taylor. Man on the left side is Brown. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Here we go.
On first down, it's Taylor. And he's got his receiver. That's Sammy Watkins. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there, a 22.
Here we go!
Now Taylor with a draw to McCoy. And he's brought down. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
From the red zone now, here's Taylor on first down. And it's going to be incomplete. The intended receiver was Corey Brown. And it's second down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call.
Offense.
They were looking to throw, holding on a big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide.
Here we go.
Usually got to pick up all
the time. On second down, here's Taylor. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Not that time for Watkins. And that'll make it third down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him. Don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to him every time he's dropped the pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. And that's incomplete. Well, too much oomph. Too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
And Hauschka's kick is good. But hang on, a flag is down. Now, if it's on the defense, they might decline it and take the points. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag.
but you caused the play. You did it.
That's Taylor throw. And his throw is incomplete. He was trying to get it to LeSean McCoy, and that'll bring up second down.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's when he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Taylor now, a throw on third down. Not being stopped for no gain, and it'll lead to a fourth down. On fourth down, Sean McDermott trots the field goal unit out there. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And Hauschka's kick is good. And they can get themselves on the board here at 14-3. So a field goal here, they're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good, because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
And good starting field position. They'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. Offense looking to avoid a third and long at second and 10.
You seriously just get the halftime of the Super Bowl? Who does that?
It's a Super Bowl. Watch the halftime show. All right, here we go. Third quarter action now. Gets around him. Take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys. But be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a run.
Jarvis Landry! That's the 20! And he is down deep into Buffalo territory. It's a big play there for Miami. And even 50 yards. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz. We're able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion. In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot,
he's got it! Touchdown, Dolphins! Julius Thomas, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead. I think it's important to get the first score in the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind. Because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. Looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
Franks to add the PAT. And it's 21-3. Here's Franks now to kick this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. They'll take this across the 25 couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game, a chance for the offense to put something on the board and get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know, in the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play.
How many plays do you script?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripted 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripted more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
Now he's going to go deep down the left side. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. In the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver go up and make a big play for me?
Let's go, and down he goes. He didn't get rid of the football there, took the sack. Although that's easier said than done. He can't just chuck the thing sideways into the seats.
No, he really can't, because you're not affording total protection as a quarterback. You have to get outside of the tackle boxes as defined by the NFL, meaning wherever your tackles operate normally, get outside of that. And the ball that you throw has to get back to at least the line of scrimmage. Otherwise, you're facing an intentional grounding call.
Third and long. Taylor and company hoping to regroup after the sack. One quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. The Bills have the football, but they trail here as we begin quarter number four. Third and long, it's Taylor. It's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on. They just play better than that.
Here we go. It's Taylor on fourth down. And this is going to be incomplete. The Bills drive stalls out on fourth down. And the Dolphins get the football in great field position. A gutsy decision there at this stage of the second half in their own territory. And a decision that they might regret.
Can't wait for the postmortem. You know, this post-game press conference, because the questions are going to come fast and furious about this decision. No matter how the game turns out, right? What were you thinking there? Why? Did you have a certain play call? Were you confident in your defense? Oh, yeah. Why? It's going to keep coming up.
Yeah, no matter the scoreboard, just tough to justify. Yeah, that is incomplete, but a penalty flag is down. This could possibly be a push-off. Looked like some hands both ways. They got it on the offense.
Sometimes there's a fine line between being the receiver and the DB, and he knocked that one away. Might have caused an incompletion. It could have been an interception.
They'll run it now. Out of the gun. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave him with a third and 11. Time for a break. We're back to crown a champion after this. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Tannehill now a throw. He's going to fire one deep. This is caught inside the 15. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A big third down conversion with a gain of 28.
Partners, a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now you can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
Throwing now, Tannehill. That's caught. 11 more on that one, and a
touchdown.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Tannehill. And that is incomplete here. He was looking to get it to Jarvis Landry that time. That'll bring up second down.
Those strong windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception.
And then he scores. Touchdown, Miami. Devontae Parker, his second touchdown in Super Bowl. And the Dolphins add on to their lead.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air, because right now, we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listen to history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in for Brock.
Yeah. You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
And they open the lead up now to 25 points. That time a six-play drive. And it winds up in 6 points for the Dolphins. Here's Franks now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And the Bills getting set to go. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge. And someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand. I'm like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here." And it just saw me some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better.
Yeah.
As they continue to play, as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. First and 10, it's Taylor. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Give him 9 there for the first down completion. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
Again, that's Watkins. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. The throw at first down with Taylor. The Dolphins get there this time and they bring him down. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go in the football game. So the defense has put them in a tough spot, second and long. Here's Taylor. From the gun, he'll throw. Wide open, the receiver complete. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Andre Holmes, 45 yards. And the Bills get a bit closer. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, that being practice sessions, and I'd hear 9 from the receivers. That meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way to the end zone for the touchdown.
Here's Hauschka now to kick it away. Field it about a yard deep. He juked him. Oh, now he bowls him over. Breaks the tackle. Now an alley. 30, 20, 10.
Yeah.
Takes it in for the score on the game's final play, so it doesn't affect the outcome. They're going to whip cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lamb, yeah, a little extra on top. That was a special return, and it happened because he's a special returner. He has to have that approval from the a special teams coach's head coach to bring it out of the end zone.
But let's be honest, a lot of times when they bring it out of the end zone like he did there, they don't have approval. I mean, I think a lot of times they do, but correct me if I'm wrong, sometimes it's just a guy getting a feel, right?
Yeah, exactly right. What's the old adage? Sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules, and if you do, you're taking on some responsibility. But he was happy to do so there.
Now the final act of this victory, the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. And the Lombardi Trophy has a home in South Florida. The Miami Dolphins are your Super Bowl champions. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them, a fantastic season.
This year, just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.